Let me show you something cool. In Chrome DevTools, we can easily open up the source code for a website. All we need to do is open up DevTools, which I'll be doing by pressing Command Option I, and then we'll go to the Sources pane. Here in Sources, we can see all of the source code that led to the website we see behind us. So index.html should look pretty familiar, and we can open up JavaScript, and we can see helper.js, jQuery, and resumebuilder.js. Let's open up helper.js. Over here, we can see it. Let's give ourselves a little bit more room. And I'm going to scroll down. Inside helper.js, we've got all of the strings containing the HTML we wanted to add to the page. And we can find some functions down at the bottom. This JavaScript down here is actually creating the map that we see on the page. But there'll be more on that in a little bit. For right now, let's pay attention to this line right here. Inside this function called locationFinder, we see this statement that says return locations. We've seen this return keyword a few times so far, but we haven't really delved into its purpose yet. It's called a return statement, and its purpose is to make the function give back a value.
I think I know what you're getting at. Why don't you explain it a bit more?
Well, remember console.log? It doesn't return anything, which means that if we were to create a new variable like this, var hello equals console.log hello, we'll get undefined when we try to run it. We see that console.log worked and printed hello. But then we also see this undefined below it. If we try to examine the variable later by just typing out hello and pressing enter, we see undefined. That's because console.log didn't return anything. It didn't give anything back. However, most functions actually do return values.
Like a lot of string methods?
Yeah, let's look at string.split. First, we'll create a string like this one. I've created a string called myString, and I've set it equal to, this is my favorite string. Then we're going to go ahead and separate this string on spaces, meaning that we'll get each word by itself. Split works like so. It's going to act on the string here, and it's going to separate it based on the parameter here. This parameter is just a single space, so we should get an array of the words from myString. Let's go ahead and save it to the variable myArray and press enter. Okay, and when we try to access myArray, we see an array of strings. This is my favorite string, each of the words from myString before. In other words, split returned an array of strings, which is now equal to myArray.
Oh, I see. When we write functions that we want to turn into a value, they must give us back a value. Looking at this function as a whole, the parameter is the input. The function does something using that parameter on the actual string, and then it gives us some sort of value.
Let's think about the resume's JSON data and all of the locations in it. For this quiz, I want you to write a function called locationizer that's going to take in the work object. Locationizer should return an array of the locations from your work object. Remember, work contains all of the jobs that you've had in the past, and each one of which should have a location associated with it. We want you to return an array of those locations. You might find it helpful to use the array.push method, which is going to add values to the end of an array. When you get to the quiz, you'll see a sample JSON that your code will iterate through. Good luck!